bright sunset tower with Gareth Palliser. How have you been this evening? Has it been fun?
Yeah, it's been very enjoyable. We've done the stadium tour, we've had a bit of a Q&A, a bit of a quiz.
Yeah.
So it's all good. I was over in Norway, in Oslo, about a year or so ago with some of the supporters. I had a great time over there with Brian Robson and Norman Whiteside and the like. So, yeah, it's always good to meet up with you guys.
Yeah. Just going to talk a little bit about the team now. Unfortunately, Phil Jones, he's out in tomorrow's game, but it started quite well this season. What do you make of Phil Jones' comeback to the team somewhere?
I think he's been terrific. You know, there was questions asked about Phil. He couldn't keep fit. He was maybe having a crisis of confidence. There was talk about whether Mourinho was a big fan of his. But he's kept himself fit during the close season. He's got a full pre-season under his belt. And he's looking like the player that we saw arrive here 5 years ago. And he's been absolutely outstanding. So he's making that shirt his own right now. The Bailly-Jones partnership seems to be the one that he prefers at the moment. Not to say that can't change. But he's really grasped the opportunity and looks the player that we bought all them years ago, and he's starting to fulfill the potential that he showed back then.
Yeah, another competitor Jones has now is Victor Lindelof. You obviously described yourself by some as a fast, ball-playing centre-back. Is it like Lindelof? What do you make of him? Do you think it would take a long time to see him in the starting
lineup? I think he's taking a little bit of time to settle in. He's had a tough start to his Manchester United career. This place can certainly do it to players. When you walk through these doors, even though he's been with a club the size of Benfica, Manchester United is a different animal altogether. The expectation, the size of it, the history of the club, I think it takes a little bit of getting used to sometimes. And I think he's maybe found that. Jose is trying to integrate him into the team slowly. He played on Wednesday in a back three and played well. So maybe that's a start of him getting more games, but at this moment in time, as we just talked about, both Jones and Bailly seem to be the preferred centre-back partnerships when we're playing a back four. So, you know, he's got to bide his time, which is the same as Mkhitaryan did last year. He didn't play for maybe three or four months before the manager started playing him more and more and more. And I think that's the way he likes to do it. So, you know, he bides his time, takes his chances when he gets them. And we see where we go from there with
him. Yeah, obviously a very strong start to the season. How far do you think this team can go this season? Is the title?
Well, I think we'll be in the mix. Yeah, absolutely. I think we're a very strong side, and we're a very physical side, a very experienced side. We've got pace in the team. We've got power in the team. We've got a belief in the team after winning two trophies last year. So I think you take that through the following season. You know what it takes to win trophies. You've added to the squad, you've got a manager who knows his way around the Premier League, knows his way around Europe. I think all the ingredients are there. Obviously there's tougher tests to come than we've faced so far in the season. But I think there's a feeling that we can certainly compete for the title this year. We're winning games at home that we were drawing last year. We're scoring goals. We look threatening. So, as I say, there's bigger tests to come, but at this moment we're ticking all the boxes. Yeah.
And lastly, how do you think we'll do against Palace tomorrow? What's the score going to be?
Well, Palace have got their own problems. They've not scored a goal, they've not picked up a point. You've got to look at the form book and say we look massive favourites. Listen, you can't go into a game thinking it's going to be a walkover, thinking it's going to be easy. They've got Zaha missing, they've got Benteke missing. They've got big players missing from their squad tomorrow. Obviously, confidence is an all-time low, so you can't see anything other than a Manchester United win, but they've got to be prepared, they've got to be ready for a battle. They've got to win the scraps early doors and show Crystal Palace that we're here to mean business tomorrow. We're looking to score goals, we're looking to put them to the sword. And all being well, it should be a comfortable win. So I would probably go for something like a 3 or 4-0 win tomorrow.
3 or 4-0.
I mean, 4-0 seems to be the score of the season so far. So who would bet against that? But I think we're too strong for Crystal Palace.
Yeah, all right.